definition of multiplication modulo p, where p is a prime integer. Let a comma b be any two integers and p be any fixed positive integer if a into b, that is the ordinary product of a and b, is divided by p such that r is the remainder, where 0 less than or equal to r less than p, we define a multiplication modulo p b equals to r. We read this as a multiplication modulo p b. Example: what is the value of 2 multiplication modulo 5 into 7? What you have to do is, we have to take the ordinary multiplication of 2 and 7. That is, the product of 2 and 7 is 14. When 14 is divided by 5, what is the remainder? So, that is the remainder of 14 divided by 5, because 2 sevens are 14. The remainder when 14 is divided by 5 is 4. Therefore, the answer is 4. 2 multiplication modulo of 5 into 7 is equals to 4. What is the value of 5 multiplication modulo of 4 into 4? What you have to do here is multiply 5 into 4. 5 fours are 20. When 20 is divided by 4, what is the remainder? That is 5 into multiplication modulo of 4 into 4 is equal to remainder when 20 is divided by 4, that is equals to 0. Therefore, the answer is 0. Now, the value of 5 multiplication modulo 4 into 4? That is, when 5 into 4, that is 5 fours are 20, is divided by 4. That is, 5 multiplication modulo 4 into 4 is equal to the remainder when 5 fours are 20 is divided by 4, the remainder is 0, and hence the answer is 0. Similarly, 12 multiplication modulo 11 into 6. Here, we have to find the remainder when 12 into 6 is divided by 11. 12, 6 are 72. When 72 is divided by 11, the remainder is 6. 9 multiplication modulo 7 into 5. That is the remainder when 9 into 5, 9 5s are 45, is divided by 7. The 45 divided by 7 gives the remainder 3. Therefore, 3 is the answer. Note: a into b is less than m, then a multiplication modulo m into b is ab modulo m. Example: what is the value of 2 multiplication modulo 7 into 3? Here a is 2, b is 3. Therefore, the product a into b is 6, m is equal to 7. That is, AB is 6, M is 7. Clearly, 6 is less than 7. That is, AB is less than M. Then, A multiplication modulo M into B is AB. Therefore, here the answer is 3 2s are 6. Because 6 is less than 7. What is the value of minus 32 multiplication modulo 4 into 5? That is equals to This is the remainder when minus 32 into 5 divided by 4. We know that clearly 4 divides 32. Therefore, without taking the product, you can write the answer is 0. That is, you can have the values of A and B may be negative, but this number must be positive. Now, what are prime integers? An integer P is said to be a prime integer and P is not equal to 0 and P is not equal to plus or minus 1, and the only divisors of P are plus or minus 1 and plus or minus P. Definition of prime integers. An integer P is said to be a prime integer if P is not equal to 0, P is not equal to plus or minus 1, and the only divisors of P are plus or minus 1 and plus or minus P. For example, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 5, plus or minus 7, plus or minus 11, plus or minus 13, so on are prime integers. If you want to take only the positive prime integers, then we have to consider 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, so on. We shall now prove a theorem. The name of the theorem is the multiplicative group of integers modulo P, where P is a prime integer. The statement of this theorem is the set G of P minus 1 integers, namely 1, 2, 3, so on, P minus 1, where P being a prime number, forms a finite abelian group of order P minus 1 with respect to the multiplication modulo P. Proof: we are given the set G equals to the set 1, 2, 3, so on, P minus 1, where P being a prime and the operation multiplication P be the multiplication modulo P. Closure axiom: for all A, B belong to G implies A multiplication modulo P, B belongs to G. Therefore, let us choose two arbitrary elements from the set G. Let A, B belong to G. Since A is an element of G, it may be any one of these numbers, that is from 1 to P minus 1. Therefore, we can write A belongs to G implies 1 less than or equal to A less than or equal to P minus 1. And B also belongs to G, therefore this P is from 1 to P minus 1. Now we have to show that A multiplication modulo P, B belong to G. That is, the value of this is any one of these numbers, namely 1, 2, 3 up to P minus 1. By definition, A multiplication modulo P, B equals to R, where R is the remainder when the ordinary product A and B is divided by P. Since P is prime, A into B is not divisible by P. For example, if you take P equal to 7, because P is a prime number, therefore 7 is a prime number, take A equal to 3 and B equal to 5, because A and B both must be less than P or maybe equals to P minus 1, then the product A into B equals to 3 into 5 equal to 15, which is not divisible by P equal to 7. That is, since P is prime, AB is not divisible by P. When you say some number is divisible by P, if the remainder is 0, But here AB is not divisible by P, the remainder cannot be 0, therefore we say R is the remainder, is not equal to 0. And we shall have the value of R from 1 to P minus 1, that is 1 less or equal to R less or equal to P minus 1. That is, the value of R is from 1 to P minus 1. The elements of G are from 1 to P minus 1. Therefore, clearly this R belongs to G, because R is any number from 1 to P minus 1. What is R? R value is A multiplication modulo P into B. Therefore, when you say R belongs to G, we can write A multiplication modulo P, B belong to G. Thus, we choose any two elements from G, then A multiplication modulo P into B belongs to G. Thus, the set G is closed. Or we say G is closed with respect to multiplication modulo P. Now, we will prove the associativity axiom. The axiom says that for all A comma B comma C belong to G implies A multiplication modulo P B into multiplication modulo P into C is equals to A multiplication modulo P into B multiplication modulo P into C. First, let us consider the left hand side. That is A multiplication modulo P, B into multiplication modulo P into C. Normally, whenever something is in bracket, we will first simplify that. Therefore, A multiplication modulo P into B can be written as AB, because A multiplication modulo P into B is AB mod P, and hence this can be written as simply the ordinary product AB into multiplication modulo P into C. Now, this is like A, this is like B. What is A multiplication modulo P into B? A multiplication modulo P into B is the remainder when A into B is divided by P. Therefore, here this AB multiplication modulo P into C is the remainder when AB into C is divided by P. This is the mathematical expression. When you write in terms of a sentence, this multiplication modulo P is replaced by the remainder when the product is divisible by P. What are A, B and C? A, B, C are elements of G. What is C? What is G? G is having, G is a set having elements from 1 to P minus 1. They are all integers, and we know that the integers obey associative property. Therefore, now AB into C can be written as A into BC. Therefore, the above expression is equals to remainder when A into BC is divided by P. The same sentence can be written in mathematical expression, namely A multiplication modulo P into BC. And see that here AB is there, therefore bracket for AB. Here BC is there, therefore bracket for BC. And hence AB into C is equal to BC mod P. Therefore, this BC can be written as B multiplication modulo P into C. Thus, A multiplication modulo P into B, multiplication modulo P into C is equals to A multiplication modulo P into B multiplication modulo P into C. Therefore, G satisfies associative law with respect to the matrix multiplication P, where P is a prime number. We now find the identity element of the set G. For all A comma B belong to G, there exists E belongs to G such that A into multiplication modulo P into E is equal to A, that is equals to E into multiplication modulo P into A. This is the existence of identity law. Here E is the identity element. Now our aim is to find the value of E. Since G consists of elements from 1 to P minus 1, it is clear that 1 belongs to G implies A into multiplication modulo P into 1 is equals to A, that is equals to 1 into multiplication modulo P into A. This implies 1 is the identity element in G with respect to multiplication modulo P. Now the important part is to find the inverse of each and every element in the set G. The existence of inverse axiom says that for all A belong to G, there exists A inverse belong to G implies A into multiplication modulo P, A inverse is equals to 1, because the identity is 1, that is equal to A inverse multiplication modulo P into A. Now choose an arbitrary element from G. Let A belong to G. Now we are going to find the inverse of A. Now we are going to show that inverse of A exists in G, and that is also one of the elements of the set G. Since A belongs to G, A must be from 1 to P minus 1, because G has elements 1, 2, 3 up to P minus 1. Now consider the following P minus 1 products, that is 1 multiplication modulo P into A, 2 multiplication modulo P into A, so 1 P minus 1 multiplication modulo P into A. That is, we multiply each and every element of G by A. All these are elements of G by closure law. Because A is an element of G, 1 is an element of G, so 1 multiplication modulo P into A must be in G. Similarly, 2 is from G, A is from G, P minus 1 is from G, A is from G, and hence P minus 1 multiplication modulo P into A also belongs to G. And hence, there are P minus 1 elements, and these P minus 1 elements of G are by closure property. Now, all these elements are distinct, that is different, for the following reason. For this, let us consider I and J be any two integers such that I is from 1 to P minus 1 and J is also from 1 to P minus 1, and from this we say that I and J are elements of P. Elements of G, because I and J both belong to G, because I and J are from 1 to P minus 1 and the elements of G are from 1 to P minus 1, and we assume that I is greater than J. We can also take J is greater than I. Suppose P is 7, because P is a prime number. Let us take P equal to 7 and I is equal to 2, J equal to 1, because I must be more than J. Now what is the difference I minus J? I minus J is 2 minus 1 is 1. Now the other case is, let us take I is equal to 6 and J equal to 1. What's the difference? The difference is I minus j is 6 minus 1 equal to 5, which is less than p minus 1. Therefore, now we can say that 1 less than or equal to I minus j less than p minus 1. We are taking two extreme cases, namely here I minus j is 1, here I minus j is 5, which is less than p. If possible, I multiplication modulo p into a is equals to j multiplication modulo p into a. That is, two of the elements of 1 are equal, because 1 consists of p minus 1 products. This is one product, this is another product, because A is from G, I is also from G, and by closure property, I multiplication modulo P into A must be any one of these products. Similarly, J multiplication modulo P into A is one of these products. But what you have to show that? We have to show that all these elements are distinct. Now we are going to prove this by contradiction. For that sake, we consider, if possible, I multiplication modulo P into A is equal to J multiplication modulo P into A. What do you mean by this? This implies the remainder, because whenever multiplication modulo P is there, A multiplication modulo P into B is equal to the remainder, where A into B is divided by P. Therefore, I multiplication modulo P into A implies the remainder when I into A is divided by P. We have an equal sign, and J multiplication modulo P into A, that is the remainder when J into A is divided by P. That is, IA and JA both leave the same remainder, because equal sign, when each is divided by P. This implies their difference, namely IA minus JA is divisible by P. That is, since they leave the same remainder, the difference must be either 0 or any multiples of P. It can be P or 2 times P or 3 times P, so on. So the difference is divisible by P. Take A is a common factor from this, then this implies I minus J into A is divisible by P. By number theory, this implies P divides I minus J, or P divides A. Is it possible P divides I minus J and P divides A? No. Which is absurd. Why? Because since P is prime, A is less than P, because A is an element of G, and I minus J is less than P minus 1. Just now we have taken that. This implies P cannot divide A. Any prime number does not divide any number which is less than itself. For example, P is 7, A is 5. Can you say 7 divides 5? No chance at all. No, not at all. Similarly, I minus J is less than P minus 1. Therefore, P also does not divide I minus J. So, P does not divide A and P does not divide I minus J. But here we have arrived at either P divides I minus J or P divides A, which is absurd. Why this happens? Because we assumed that I multiplication modulo P into A is equals to J multiplication modulo P into A. That is, two of the elements of the product are equal. So because of this, we have a contradiction. And hence, what you do? We have to change our supposition. That is, this I multiplication modulo P into A can never be equals to J multiplication modulo P into A, for I, comma j, comma a are the elements of G. Therefore, we say that I multiplication modulo P into A is not equals to J multiplication modulo P into A. And hence, all the elements in the product 1, namely 1 into multiplication modulo P into A, comma 2 multiplication modulo P into A, so on, P minus 1 into multiplication modulo P, A are all distinct elements of G. That is, the different elements of G. Since G equals to the set containing the elements 1, 2, 3, so on, P minus 1. One of these elements must be 1. And see here, this G contains P minus 1 elements. And this product, 1 multiplication modulo P into A, comma 2 multiplication modulo P into A, so on, P minus 1 multiplication modulo P into A, are also P minus 1 elements and they are elements of G. G has P minus 1 elements from 1 to P minus 1. And these P minus 1 elements are also elements of G. And hence, among these products, one of them must be the number 1. So let, which is the 1? We don't know. Therefore, let A inverse multiplication modulo P into A equals to 1. Here A inverse may be any one of 1, 2, 3, so on, P minus 1. Therefore, A inverse is the left inverse of A. For example, let us consider if P equal to 7 and A equal to 4, then A inverse multiplication modulo 7 into 4 must be equals to 1. Whenever this A inverse multiplication modulo P 4 equal to 1, then A inverse must be 2. The reason is, when 2 into 4, 2 fours are 8, when 8 is divided by 7, 1 is the remainder. That is, A inverse is equal to 2. This implies inverse of A is A inverse, that is, inverse of 4 is 2. Let us take A equal to 6. Then A inverse multiplication modulo 7 into 6 must be equal to 1. Then the only value of A inverse is 6, because 6, 6 are 36. When 36 is divided by 7, the remainder is 1. This implies the inverse of 6 is 6. Thus, we can find the inverse of each and every element in the set G. So, similarly, we get A into A inverse equals to 1. Hence, each element in G is invertible. Therefore, the algebraic structure G, multiplication modulo P is a group. Now, we have to show that it is abelian. For that, we have to show that it satisfies commutative law. What is the commutative axiom? The commutative axiom is, for all A comma B belong to G, implies A multiplication modulo P into B equals to B multiplication modulo P into A. Let us consider A multiplication modulo P B. By definition of multiplication modulo P, this is the remainder when A into B is divided by P. What are A and B? A and B are elements of G. What are elements of G? Elements of G are from 1 to P minus 1, where P is a prime number. Therefore, A and P are nothing but integers. And we know that set of integers obey commutative property. And hence, in the place of A into B, we can write B into A. Therefore, remainder when B into A is divided by P. Here, A multiplication modulo P into B. So, we write A first. But here, which is first? B is first. Therefore, we have to write B, multiplication modulo P into A. Therefore, G satisfies commutative law with respect to multiplication modulo P. Thus, G satisfies all the five axioms, namely closure axiom, associative axiom, identity, inverse, and commutative law. Therefore, the algebraic structure G, multiplication modulo P is an abelian group.